Hey guys, welcome back to part two of the forging a bushcraft knife video. It's great to have you back again. We're going to start this video out today just by grinding the flats on our knife here, and then we're just going to carry on from there. Okay, so now I'm just going to use a file on a few areas on the profile that I think need some attention. Fine details of the profile sorted out now, so now I'm going to begin grinding the bevels. Okay, so before I heat treat the blade, I'm going to drill a few holes in the tang for two Corby fasteners and one brass tube for a lanyard loophole. So I'm going to mark everything up and then we're just going to pop the holes in it. Okay, so I think it'll look alright if I put my holes right here where I've marked. I'm just going to go ahead and center punch them and then start drilling the holes. Start drilling the holes now. Okay, and after a little bit of a struggle and some swearing, I got all three holes drilled in here. So now it's on to the normalizing cycle. Alright, I'm going to start heating up the blade here to normalize it in a couple cycles. But first thing I'm going to do is put my touch mark in it. After it's hot, of course. One normalizing cycle, I'm just gonna let it cool down until it's like
completely black, basically. Alright, so it's all black again.
Okay, so now that the normalizing process is all complete, I'm going to put some clay on the spine of the knife to form a hamon when I do the heat treating. I just got some refractory cement or furnace cement here. Okay, so I think this is going to yield a pretty decent hamon, so I'm just going to let this one side dry here for a while, and I'm going to flip it over and just repeat the process.
And here is the opposite side.
Okay, I'm now going to temper the blade at 400 degrees for 3 1-hour cycles. Okay, so here's the blade after it's been tempered. And I'm just going to do a couple of toughness checks. Make sure it doesn't break in half or crack. Tip snap off. Thank you.
so the blade's ran out of the acid, and now I'm just going to start polishing it up with some 2000 grit sandpaper. So here I'm just making sure the holes stay lined up perfectly with the holes on the tang with these drill bits and a little lanyard loop thing. So now I'm just going to line up the other scale so it's perfectly flush with the other scale, and then I'm going to clamp it. Okay, again I have put the C-clamps on there so there's no possibility of anything getting misaligned. And now I'm gonna drill the holes all the way through to the other side now. Degrade any oils that are on the tang. Thank you.
is the completed knife. And it still has a few flaws, but overall I think I'm pretty happy with it.
Watching you guys. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram.